Thank you very much for the invitation. And living up in Nordic countries, we experience sun as a source of glare. So sun is low for most part of the time, and people are annoyed by the glare. So using sunlight indoors as a source of illumination is not easy. For a long time, I was very frustrated because I think that there is a paradox. The most profound paradox in daylighting is related to the utilization of direct sunlight. And huge luminous intensity creates great potential for its utilization as a light source. However, in common practice, sunlight is mostly kept away by various forms of sun shading devices, and electric light is used for lighting even during sunny days. So we need to optimize its penetration and find smarter ways to distribute it in interiors, so it certainly does not create visual or thermal discomfort. The task is especially challenging in regions with high frequency of overcast sky, where the utilization of sunlight should not be done at the expense of effective use of diffuse light from the sky. So I will discuss this issue on using two examples. The first one is a detached house that I designed for some years ago. And we see two pictures here from living room. And to the left, you see sun patches. And you can imagine this is the same roof, the same room. Here on the right side, you see the skylight with mirrors. And the sunlight sometimes goes through, sometimes it's reflected, and causes those light patches. And very important question is how intense is actually the sunlight, and how intense would we like it to be? Do we know any numbers? Is it okay, 15,000 candela per square meter or not? There are not so many sources that we can use as references to find which number should we use as a border for acceptable or not acceptable level. But in the well-building standard developed some years ago in the US, we can find some numbers that are used for electrical light. And to be very strict, we can look here down at the number of 8,000 candela per square meter that is recommended as a highest level for workstations, desk, and other sitting areas. So we can probably try to use this number also for sunlighting. Another possibility is to use 20,000 candela per square meter, and it is for regularly occupied spaces. So back to this example, what does it mean actually 8,000 candela per square meter? And of course it can be translated to lux, and it depends on the reflectance of the surfaces. So for a white surface, as we have example to the left, with reflectance over 0.9, it means in practice that you can have illuminance up to 30,000 lux. And of course, if you have lower reflectance, like wooden roof to the right, so then you can have up to 50,000 lux. Sun diagram from Oslo showing that the sun solar angle in Nordic countries is really low. So it's the highest solar angle is about 50 degrees. And here I made some calculations just to examine how we can actually use sunlight and still keep the visual comfort and keep luminance of the surfaces below 8,000 candela per square meter. So here in this table you have solar elevation angle and outdoor illuminance on the horizontal plan and outdoor illuminance on the surface normal to the sun rays. And here and here is calculation for illuminance if the slant angle increases from 10 degrees up to 50 degrees. So shortly speaking, if you see the number in yellow, it means that the value of illuminance is higher than 30,000 lux, and it means that it is higher than 8,000 candela per square, square meter. So those areas where you have black numbers means that you can use sunlight by orientating surfaces with a slant angle, a rather low slant angle, and avoid any form for discomfort. And in previous projects, we were very much concerned about not allowing sunlight passing through roof lights, like here in this school. So sunlight is diffused on the surface of the well and will never penetrate down to the room because of the well proportions. So much light will be, of course, reflected back to the atmosphere. And to avoid this, you have to use other type of surface, not diffuse, but specular. So of course, mirrors are a good possibility. And of course, you can use slant angle principle. So you, instead of designing room with horizontal ceilings, you may try to orient surfaces around the skylight in the way that the sunlight is distributed over much larger areas, like here. And in this example, solar angle is 45 and slant angle is 15. And of course, it's absolutely no any glare. And the view of sky through this skylight. If you are curious about this building, so it's a detached building, and the room with pyramid is up there. And HDR picture showing that the room has rotation symmetry, and the light level on all walls is very, very similar. And in addition, the coloration of the walls is inspired by by the surroundings out there. So we're starting from deep green and going up with different levels, nuances of green up to white color, yellow and white. And something that is important, the sun patches stay high on the wall and will never hit the eyes of users. And the last picture from this house, like, it looks like here. Okay, and now the second example, we are changing the place is a retrofitting project of the student studio at the university campus. And you see the place here. And the objectives of the project was to maximize the provision of daylight, both sunlight and diffuse light from the sky, create good visual conditions, and keep the energy consumption for heating at the same level as before. So this is an existing room that we had possibility to change. And existing solution, the previous solution you see on the left side, it was canal channel plastic panels with rather low transparency. So the new solution was to remove them and use just three-layer clear glazing. And on the shafts, we used mirrors. And what about these solar patches? We have to make something. And two most promising alternatives was to scatter the light on the surface of the shaft or use a transparent scattering, like on the right side. So at the end, we chose the second alternative, and we developed a new material for this purpose. And as usual in developing of new material, we had to make many alternatives, designer alternatives of this material. It's acrylic sheet cut with laser cutter, and we tested different patterns and used our laboratory to really understand how all those different alternatives may function. So you see how the light approach, and we start with various diffuse surfaces on the shift around the skylight. And now on the shift, the silver foil is used, simulating just a mirror in a real building. And we see that the penetration of sunlight is much improved, but still the light patches are very strong. So then we are trying material number one, and some of the light is distributed more, but we are not totally happy. So we are trying again and again. At the end, we have a solution that works very well. I mean, the light, instead of falling on the surfaces and having very strong luminance, is much more distributed in the whole. So you have this last alternative here with the panel. And this alternative was actually built. So here you have pictures showing the old solution and the new solution, and pictures from the room, the old solution here and the new solution here. So it's much brighter, and it looks more cleaner because the color of the light is also more. And HDR pictures of the old and new, both in overcast sky on the upper part and clear sky down there. And of course, we measured daylight level during last summer when the students were on vacation. And you see the results. So in terms of daylight factor, you have old solution and new solution. And it was really a huge improvement. And in sunny conditions, it's more or less the same. So the average light level is increased 2-3 times. So, principles of utilization of sunlight. Of course, this is for Nordic countries, I will say. High and deep penetration of diffuse sky, especially from the zenith. Second rule, effective transport of light through the climate skin. So use specular materials on the light well, and control that the reflected sunlight does not hit the human eye. The third one, distribute the sunlight on large diffuse surfaces. So use slant angle. And the last one, scatter the sunlight partly or totally to avoid high luminance of sun patches. The 8,000 candela per square meter may be a limit for stay long places, and 20,000 candela per square meter for highest value in occupied rooms. So that's all my conclusions from those studies, and thank you very much.